From WSLS 10.
Live from WSLS, this is Virginia Today from 10 News, working for you.
Out in the public, a look at the highly anticipated Russian report and what people on Capitol Hill are saying. And severe weather is headed our way. Storm Team 10's tracking the rain and strong winds ahead of your Easter weekend. Good morning and happy Friday to you. We thank you for waking up with us. I'm Patrick McKee. Jenna has the morning off. I do want to let you know Charlotte County schools are going to be closing early today at 12:30 this afternoon, likely ahead of the severe weather that's expected later today. As we give you a live look over the Roanoke Valley, things are calm as we start off the day. A little breezy for us this morning. Let's get over to Jonathan Kegas. He's working for you on what you need to know as severe storms are in the forecast. Again, Jonathan, how strong could these be?
Yeah, these could be like something we haven't seen in quite some time, Patrick. So it's a good idea that the superintendent's watching, pay close attention to when kids are getting out of school today. It's one of those kind of days. A moderate risk has now been outlooked by the Storm Prediction Center. It's something we rarely see around these parts. And again, damaging wind far and away the main threat, but tornadoes are not out of the question. Especially across Southside, you see that darker red there, mainly areas east of the Blue Ridge, from really the yellows to the reds. Everyone under the gun, but the most significant severe weather threat going to come east of the Blue Ridge. Again, main threats with this going to be damaging winds, very heavy rain, and the potential for tornadoes going to be there. Right now we are quiet, just a few showers for your morning commute. Temperatures are warm and muggy, and that is going to help to fuel the storms. Remember, as we've been talking about for the last few days, this is a situation that you do not need sunshine, so don't let your guard down as we are stuck in the clouds. Sunshine is not needed for a day like today. We're going to talk much more about this risk, Patrick, coming up at 5:11. First, I do want to get you a check on those roads this morning with your Time Saver traffic report.
We're on area roadways this morning with the green showing up. No accidents to tell you about right now. Congress and the public are digesting the redacted Mueller report, both its findings and the way in which they were released. Attorney General William Barr's favorable assessment was followed by the report, which includes extensive evidence of obstruction and unflattering, possibly politically damaging assessment of the president. Tracy Potts is on Capitol Hill with more reaction from lawmakers.
President Trump takes a second victory lap.
It was called No Collusion, No Obstruction.
But for Democrats, the Mueller report raises more questions than answers.
It's certainly not game over.
The report outlines 10 areas of possible obstruction, including multiple attempts to fire Special Counsel Robert Mueller. Mueller says he could not determine the president's intent.
Those acts of obstruction of justice, whether they are criminal or not, are deeply alarming.
Mueller left it to Congress to follow up.
And the responsibility now falls to Congress to hold the president accountable for his actions.
They not only want the full report.
No one outside the department has seen the unredacted report.
They want Mueller to testify.
I want to be able to ask Mr. Mueller, who is a former Republican-appointed FBI director, about what happened with this investigation.
Republicans deny Attorney General William Barr.
No collusion.
Gave the report a positive spin for President Trump.
I think it's rather laughable to see them turn their guns on him.
The report revealed President Trump was terrified when Mueller was appointed, telling aides, "This is the end of my presidency." The president's legal team had their own counter report all ready to go, but now the president's attorney says they probably won't release it. In Washington, Tracy Potts, 10 News, working for you.
We'll have continuing coverage of the Mueller report here on 10 News throughout the day and next on the Today Show at 7. Infinite gratitude and eternal appreciation. That's the praise given to first responders in Paris. Thousands gathered outside City Hall to honor the firefighters who saved Notre Dame Cathedral. France's interior minister says they will never be able to give them enough praise. Many of the relics inside were saved by them, including the crown of thorns and tunic of St. Louis. A local sheriff's office is remembering one deputy's beautiful personality and commitment to her work. Deputy Rose Clark died this week. Sheriff David Hill tells 10 News he believes she died of natural causes. He says she returned to Nelson County and applied at the sheriff's office to work in the courthouse and serve papers.
Very loyal appointee, employee.
And she was just a fine representation of our office, the community, the citizens, her family.
Every day when I would come in, I'd say, "Hello, Rose," and she would say, "Hi, Charlie," and it was such an infectious smile.
According to Hill, Clark also worked in Charlottesville for more than a decade before retiring in November. You can find their full statement at WSLS.com. New this morning, if you're headed out of town soon, you may want to pack hand sanitizer. Travel can be a germy endeavor, especially if you're flying to your final destination. A recent study finds airport security bins can carry more germs than a toilet. If you buy food at one of those airport grab-and-go stands, check the label to make sure the food isn't expired. Doctors at Baylor College of Medicine say spoiled food could cause food poisoning. When you get to your seat, wipe down the tray table before you eat on them. And even if you thoroughly cleaned, hotel rooms can harbor bacteria in some sneaky places. Baylor suggests using antiseptic wipes on remotes, the telephone, and light switches. It's also a good idea to wash out glasses that are left in bathrooms. Even if they're clean, studies have shown flushing toilets can contaminate nearby surfaces. A major upgrade, or some Southwest Virginia communities are getting recognition. Three local areas are in the top 10 list of Virginia's safest cities. SafeHome.org ranked Salem as fifth safest. The study found only 16 violent crimes happened there last year. Rounding out the top 10 is Lynchburg at number 8 and Christiansburg at number 9. A major upgrade to the local power grid. Appalachian Power just finished $38 million in renovations in downtown Roanoke. At first glance, you won't notice it because it's all underground. 10 News got an exclusive look at the new underground system that's expected to reduce the number of power outages and speed up response times. The new infrastructure is also attractive to potential businesses.
When we work with businesses that want to locate into our area, especially a downtown area, they ask about infrastructure. And now we can say that we have a brand new system in Roanoke that's ready to serve your needs.
That new system is expected to last for decades. New this morning, a team of researchers are using math to help design a fairer schedule for NFL teams. Right now, experts say there are more possibilities to schedule 32 teams in a year than there are atoms in the universe. Inevitably, some teams are on the short end of that stick. The Buffalo Bills have voiced their concerns. Between 2002 and 2014, the Bills have twice as many games against teams coming off a bye week or a Thursday night game.
You're able to improve the 2016 schedule after the fact. They like that, and that eventually led to this three-year contract.
Now the NFL is giving them access to all schedules to see if they're able to find a better approach. While researchers say there will never be a perfect schedule, they will try to minimize the number of bad things. It's 5:08 now in What's News Today. We'll get a look today at Carilion Clinic's drug take-back boxes. The boxes have been installed at all hospitals and pharmacies. You can dispose of leftover medication throughout the year. The boxes were installed in response to the opioid crisis. The New River Health District holds a walk-in clinic today. Several services will be offered, including vaccines, family planning, and testing for sexually transmitted diseases. Clinic runs from 8:30 to noon at the Montgomery County Health Department. If you're traveling for Easter, travel will get a little easier today. Road crews will lift many lane closures starting at noon today through noon on Tuesday. The Virginia Tech Corps of Cadets will take part in the Jaffe Eager Squad and Eager Individual Drill competitions today. The cadets practice for hours in the months leading up to the competition. First year and sophomore cadets will take part. 5:09, back over to Jonathan with an update on today's forecast as he's tracking today's severe weather potential.
Yeah, Patrick, right now all is quiet. We do have a mainly cloudy sky with just a couple of light showers around for your morning commute. The worst of the weather going to come this afternoon, mainly after lunch and into the evening. Here is that line we are tracking, and you see some very, very heavy rain. This is likely going to intensify as it continues to work its way off towards the east. Already severe thunderstorm watches in effect, tornado watches also in effect across the deep south. Enhanced risk across the region east of the Blue Ridge. This red box here, though, that moderate risk we were talking about earlier, something very, very rare. We typically do not see this in this part of the country, only a few times a decade, really. Severe storm threat today. Widespread severe thunderstorms are likely. Again, that is 4 out of 5 on the Storm Prediction Center severe weather scale. Again, very, very important on a day like today to be weather aware area-wide, but especially for areas along and east of Interstate 81. Now is a really, really good time to download the Storm Team 10 weather app and make sure those alerts, Patrick, are turned on.
Good advice. Thank you, Jonathan. 510 now still to come this morning, keeping your family safe. The do's and don'ts to keep in mind before you use your microwave. Then new at 540, new breast cancer guidelines. The debate over when you should start getting a mammogram. And Americans waste $160 billion in produce each year. How to make it last longer, next.
Sandwich with Tots.
It's 5:13 now. New this morning, each year about $160 billion in produce is thrown away in the United States. Here's some things you could do to lengthen its life and save a little money. Breaking your banana bunch apart can make them last 2 weeks compared to just one together. If your cheeses aren't lasting the average 3 weeks in the refrigerator, pay attention to your fingers to avoid transferring bacteria and promoting mold growth. Don't touch it when cutting. Place paper towel over lettuce to absorb moisture and prevent wilting, and store citrus in a cool, dark place to lengthen its life. For the rest of your home, make flowers last by adding a cap of vodka or bleach to the water. New this morning, the microwave is convenient to cook food quickly. We're working for you on some do's and don'ts when using the appliance. A study published in the Journal of Food Science cooked 20 different vegetables. They found microwaving and baking preserved nutrients better than boiling. Dietitian Sharila Sharma says the most common microwave dish is typically leftovers. She says you should heat food in glass containers or in paper plates and bowls. There are no major studies showing microwaving in plastics dangerous, but you should try to avoid it and make sure to stop and stir food while it's reheating.
Because otherwise, if some parts are heated more than the others, that part will cook faster than the other parts.
Now, she recommends using a thermometer to make sure vegetables and meat reach 165 degrees to eliminate bacteria. A drug 10,000 times stronger than morphine is being used recreationally. The DEA is warning about carfentanil. They say 3 people in San Diego are dead after overdosing on the synthetic opioid. The drug's normally used as a tranquilizer for large zoo animals. It's so dangerous, it poses a risk to first responders who accidentally come in contact with it.
This has no respect for anyone. Any one of us could become addicted to this drug and succumb to it. And it's extremely addicting. You only need to be exposed to it once and you will be hooked.
The DEA reports some are mixing the drug into a pill to look like OxyContin or Xanax. A local manufacturing company is moving to Floyd County, bringing 28 jobs with it. Positions at Thomas Industrial Fabrication include welders, mechanics, engineers, and office support. It will move into the former Dreaming Creek property from its current headquarters in Patrick County. The owners are from Floyd and say it's a great fit because of the high school's strong welding program. And Governor Northam announces 45 new jobs headed to Bath County. Speyside Bourbon Stave Mill in Virginia is investing over $100,000 to expand its facility. The company will add new equipment and a second shift. This time next year, construction should be well underway for a unique village in Danville. Habitat for Humanity plans to build a habitat village. We'll have a dozen homes. The announcement was made this week, but planning for the village has taken 10 years. Habitat villages are all across the country, including Lynchburg and Charlottesville. This will be the first for Danville.
Once we have a better feel for how quickly we can construct the houses, we will do a better job of, you know, being able to recruit the families. We do anticipate that this will be highly desirable.
Now, Habitat's in need of donations of labor and money for the village. To find out how you can help, head to WSLS.com. In this morning's Consumer Watch, Apple is making it easier for you to recycle old iPhones. The company's quadrupling the number of drop-off recycling locations across the nation. You can turn in your old devices at any Apple store, Best Buy, or online through the Apple Trade-In program. The company's recycling robot, Daisy, can disassemble 200 phones per hour or $1.2 million a year. Daisy also recovers important materials such as aluminum and tin, which are recycled back into the manufacturing process. Homes with solar panels not only help save on energy costs, they can also potentially increase the value of your home. According to a new report from Zillow, homes with solar energy systems sold for about 4% more than homes without. The study finds more than 80% of home buyers say energy efficient features are important. Solar panel homes sold for more than $9,000 in additional cash. Something to keep in mind if you're thinking about buying or selling a home. John Kegis is back with us with an update on this forecast, and something we've really got to keep an eye on today is the weather.
Yeah, potential is there for some strong to severe thunderstorms later on this afternoon, something we don't typically see a lot of, at least in this magnitude. We're going to get right into that forecast. All is quiet right now, and on your way into work this morning, just a few showers out there under mostly cloudy skies. Temperatures now into the mid-60s. Dew points up there into the upper 50s again. Once you start getting around 60, that's some good fuel for storms to work with. Winds are a little bit breezy. Sustain now out of the south-southeast at about 10 miles an hour. Temperatures this morning at the bus stop, we're back into the mid-50s. In Gretna, good morning. We'll see scattered showers and thunderstorms at the bus stop this morning. Most of us are dry, though, across Southside into work. It's later this afternoon. The potential going to be there for severe thunderstorms as school gets ready to let out. So, again, superintendents, teachers, please be vigilant today. It's one of those scenarios where you really have to watch when the kids are getting out of school. It's one of those kind of days. Here is that line of storms. Again, not impressive right now. That will change, though, as it works its way east. It's a very strengthening system as it works its way from west to east. You see the darker yellows and oranges there indicating the heavier rain. Tornado watch box for the panhandle of Florida into parts of Georgia and into Alabama. Again, this is the system that is sliding in this direction as we move forward into the afternoon. Tracking that here, here is after lunch, about 2 or 3 o'clock. We're going to start to watch a couple of these line segments, if you will, start to get going. And you see the darker reds here. This is what we're really concerned about towards your commute home. So really be careful. Again, the potential going to be there for some very, very strong winds and heavy rain. You see the darker reds there. Each one of these can contain wind gusts, potentially more than 70 miles an hour, and the potential, especially east of the Blue Ridge, for some tornadic development. So really, really watching this closely. Damaging wind threat today is very, very high. The flash flood threat going to be moderate. Tornado threat today, especially across Southside, is moderate, so it's more than just not zero. It's going to be a lot of lightning with these. The hail threat is going to be on the lower side of things. Not a ton of instability, but as we've been talking about for the last few days, this is a situation where you don't really need the instability. It's very, very dynamic, if you will. A lot of wind energy in the atmosphere. In terms of the tornado risk, again, the best opportunity, best in quotation marks here, to see one develop, going to be across Southside here, really from Martinsville to Danville into South Boston in this yellow shaded area. Tornadoes certainly possible along into the east of Interstate 81. Really becoming low, though, as you get into the Highlands, pretty much non-existent, though, if you get into the Newbury Valley and into the 77 corridor. But again, those damaging wind gusts are going to be the main threat. Things quiet down big time getting into Easter. There will be a slight chance for a few showers hanging around now. This system bringing us the severe weather, going to weaken considerably and just keep a few showers around as it kind of parks itself. Temperature is still going to be into the 60s on Easter Sunday. Today, the severe weather threat going to be extremely elevated today. Have a way to get your watches and warnings if they are issued. A couple of showers lingering tonight. Be on the lookout for some fog to develop in the wake of these strong storms. Much cooler tomorrow. A couple of showers still around. Not a washout, though, if you have Easter egg hunts planned for tomorrow. A few lingering showers into Sunday. Not a bad Easter Sunday, though. Much, much better and warmer getting into early next week, Patrick.
All right, thank you, John. And the time saver traffic now here at 520. Take a look at drive times this morning as we remain accident free. 26 minutes your drive, Christiansburg to Roanoke, Lexington to Roanoke coming in at 43.
Good morning. The Roanoke Rail Yard Dogs' quest to claim the SPHL President's Cup picked back up at the Berglund Center last night. The second round of postseason action put them up against the Birmingham Bulls. Here we go. Game one of the three-game set. Bulls will strike first. Within the first 5 minutes of the game, Shane Topp able to find the back of the net for the early goal in the 1-0 lead. Dogs wouldn't take long to respond. Precise passing by Roanoke sets up Adrian Carbonaro, who had a slick move. We're tied at one. Fans pumped up after that one. Still in the first period, power play for Birmingham. Garrett Schmitz is finding nothing but net. 2-1 lead for the Bulls. They go on for the 4-3 game one victory. Game two later tonight on the road, 7:30 Central Time. Washington Redskins have signed former Case Spring of Liberty QB Josh Woodrum, 6'3" quarterback, last seen in the Alliance of American Football League with the Salt Lake Stallions. Redskins also signed defensive lineman Matt Ioannidis to a 3-year extension. And that's your Sports in a Minute.
It's 5:22 now, still to come this morning. Flood fighting technology, the new system available now that can predict where rivers could flood. Plus, a successful season. Despite only being in Roanoke for a short time, the Rail Yard Dogs are celebrating. The community responds.
Today. You're watching Virginia Today from 10 News, working for you.
Welcome back. It's 5:25 now. I'm Patrick McKee. The Roanoke Rail Yard Dogs is getting ready to wrap up its third season, and the team says it's beat its mark. The Dogs made history with a trip to the semifinals for the first time ever. While the team fell to Birmingham last night, they're still in the hunt for the championship. Minor league hockey in the past has come and gone in Roanoke, which left some people skeptical. But one of the local minority owners says not only is Roanoke embracing the team loves Roanoke.
You know, I feel like we've checked a lot of the boxes. We're doing the right things. We're making hockey exciting. We're making it accessible. It's entertaining for families. If we can do that, we're doing a great service to the Valley.
Average game attendance has continued to grow each year. Last night, ticket sales were up more than 1,000 people for a normal Thursday night game. If you're worried ahead of today's storms, there's now new technology designed to help. Drones, supercomputers, and underwater sonar scans are being used to maintain flood control projects. It also can predict where rivers could flood. Scientists say 13 million Americans are at risk of major flooding damage. Emergency officials can also simulate scenarios such as predicting what could happen if a dam or levee breaks. And I know that's one of the potentials you're looking at for later today is that flooding as well as the severe weather on top of it.
Yeah, no doubt about that. This morning we are talking about just a couple of showers out there. Nice and quiet, cloudy, a few areas of fog, but for the most part we are really, really quiet. It's later this afternoon, mainly after lunch, where we're talking about that severe weather threat getting ready to slide through from about 12 until 8 o'clock tonight. That's when the entire region under the gun. Couple of showers tomorrow, but going to be much quieter and cooler. Things to remember, again, there is the potential for tornadoes today, especially across Southside, and with the severe thunderstorm warning, especially with today's, so we can have significant wind gusts in these thunderstorms. Always good to get away from the windows, tornado warning or severe thunderstorm warning. In terms of tornadoes especially, you want to make sure you are in your basement if you don't have one, in an interior room, mobile homes, get out of those for sure. Try to find some cover in a ditch or something like that. Want to make sure you're under something sturdy for sure. Always a good idea as well to make sure you're covering yourself, especially your head. That's where most injuries and fatalities with tornadoes come, when getting hit with objects that are thrown. Always a good idea to find a pillow, blanket, even a bike helmet, something like that. Something to keep in mind. We don't typically talk about this a lot, but today is certainly a day where that potential is there, Patrick.
All right, good things to keep in mind. Thank you, Jonathan. 5:27 now. Still to come this morning, getting your driving privileges back. How simple it is now to start driving again. Plus, celebrating a special birthday. Forget the presents. It's about something more from one local veteran's 100th birthday. How your acts of kindness can make all the difference. Plus, 20 years later, the technology hoping to prevent school shootings.
For sandwiches.
Live from WSLS, this is Virginia Today from 10 News, working for you.
Out of a job, the Virginia resource officer connected to a white nationalist group. Plus, learning from mistakes, a deadly decision lands a New River Valley teen in a detention center. The sentence the teen received. Good morning and happy Friday to you. Made it to the end of the week. We thank you for waking up with us. I'm Patrick McKee. Jenna is off this morning. I do want to let you know Charlotte County schools are going to be getting out early today with dismissal at 12:30 this afternoon as severe weather is likely to roll in for us later today. Live look over Martinsville, New College Institute Sky Cam. Nice and calm this morning. A bit breezy outside though. Jonathan Kegis has all the details on what we can expect later today, and this is a day you really got to watch things.
Yeah, Patrick, the potential is there for a very dangerous afternoon, especially areas east of Interstate 81. That's where that big red blob on your screen resides. That's a moderate risk for severe weather. A 4 out of 5 on the severe weather scale is issued by the Storm Prediction Center. They put out these outlooks, and you see that tornado box there. That is going to be one of the risks, especially across Southside. Damaging wind far and away the biggest risk, and these damaging wind gusts could be significant at times. pushing hurricane strength, and that is that 74-75 mile per hour ballpark. So again, this is something you really want to pay attention to later this afternoon and evening. The few showers we have out there now are just that, very, very light this morning. A nice quiet commute into work. May need the windshield wiper every now and then, but that's about it in terms of the morning. Temperatures right now in the 50s and 60s. It is muggy. That is going to help to fuel the storms. And that threat increases. You clearly see that there throughout the afternoon and into the early part of the evening. We're going to talk about the threats that we are tracking and the timing behind all of this, Patrick, coming up at 5:47. First, though, do want to get you a check on those roads this morning with your Time Saver traffic report.
And Jonathan, we are seeing great conditions across the area roads this morning with drive times coming in at 54 minutes on 460 Lynchburg to Roanoke, on 220 from Roanoke to Rocky Mount. That's a 23-minute drive. Tomorrow marks the 20th anniversary of the Columbine High School shooting. Since then, schools have turned to technology to help prevent similar events from happening. Liz McLaughlin has more on how this tech is helping.
In the two decades since Columbine, America has seen school shooting tragedies repeat themselves time and time again.
Enough is enough!
Now some hope artificial intelligence can play a role in preventing future violence.
Technology has the amazing capacity to identify those most at risk to become a threat before they actually do.
BARC is one of a handful of companies that uses AI and machine learning to analyze student activity on school-issued devices, looking for warning signs and flagging students that may harm themselves or others.
Violent gaming platforms, online chat forums, even on Google Docs, writing suicide notes or plans to commit mass attacks.
BARC then sends alerts to parents, school officials, and in the most extreme cases, law enforcement.
To date, our artificial intelligence has escalated 16 credible school shooting threats to the FBI.
BARC offers the service for free to schools, and it currently covers about 2.5 million students. There are occasional false positives, and schools can't police students' personal devices, but that's where parents can step in.
Any sort of sign that something is off with your child is a sign that you need to take a more active role in engaging with what's going on.
The hope that early intervention will curb acts of violence before they happen. Liz McLaughlin, NBC News.
A Virginia school resource officer is out of a job this morning after claims he's associated with a white nationalist group. The Chesterfield Police Department says Officer Dan Morley will not return to the force. When he started, the allegations of his association with a white supremacist group had not yet come to light. Last month, he was accused of being involved with one which has been designated a hate group by the Southern Poverty Law Center. In a statement, the police chief says, in part, policing in today's times is challenging, and to be successful, it requires trust. He says the officer's activities make it impossible for him to continue. You can read the full statement on WSLS.com. Happening today, an Ohio man accused of pretending to be a missing Kentucky boy, scheduled to be in court. 23-year-old Michael Rennie is charged with two counts of making false statements and one count of aggravated identity theft. Authorities say Rennie told investigators he was Timothy Pitson, a boy who went missing in 2011. DNA tests later determined Rennie was not the missing boy. According to investigators, Rennie came up with the ruse after watching a news story on Pitson. Local deputies are looking for two people this morning who may have witnessed a robbery outside of a bank. The Amherst County Sheriff's Office says deputies want to talk to Arthur Tucker and Shanta Wolfuck. They say the armed robbery happened last Friday in the parking lot of the Madison Heights BB&T. If you know where they are, you're asked to call police. A judge hopes the punishment handed down to a teen driver involved in a deadly crash will be a lesson to others. 16-year-old, who 10 News is not identifying because of his age, was driving when Ashland Poole was thrown from the passenger seat and killed in Christiansburg last July. An investigation found he was traveling more than 86 miles an hour, more than twice the speed limit. His sentence includes 30 days detention, community service, and his license is suspended. New this morning, many people who get their driving privileges back later this year won't have to complete anything extra to start driving legally again. According to the DMV, starting July 1st, if you have a physical license and it's not expired, you're good to get behind the wheel. If you have no physical license or an expired license, you have to go to the DMV for a replacement or renewal, but you will not have to pay the $145 reinstatement fee. The threat of severe weather is here. A look at the storms hitting us later today. Time now is 5:37.
At Belk and Belk.com.
It's 5:39 now in Women's Health this morning. The American College of Physicians issues new screening guidelines for breast cancer. They say an average risk woman should begin mammogram screenings every other year, beginning at age 50. The American College of Physicians guidelines differs from the American Cancer Society, which recommends beginning screenings at age 45 and continuing them annually until 54 and then going every other year. Performing mammograms every other year reduces the potential for false positives, overdiagnosis, overtreatment, and radiation exposure. But all women should have a conversation with their doctor to develop a plan that's right for her.
Patients should also be paying attention to self-breast exams, going in for their annual clinical exams, and then make a shared decision with their physician what's right for them.
Now, these guidelines do not apply to patients who have had prior abnormal screening results or a higher risk of breast cancer. You can help one local veteran have an even more special 100th birthday. There's a social media campaign to send the Lexington man 100 birthday cards for his big day. This picture has been shared thousands of times already, and the World War II veteran has dozens of cards already in his mailbox. His retirement home's administrator says she wanted to do something, but never imagined so many people would wish him well.
I'm not overly emotional, but some of this, when I was reading his cards to him yesterday, it kind of was hard for me to read to him because I wanted to tear up and cry because 100 years old, World War II veteran, it's just amazing. Again, nobody deserves it more than Ray.
The home is also planning a party for his birthday. If you want to mail in a card, we've got the address for you on our website, WSLS.com. Happy birthday to him. New this morning, a new favorite snack. Pickle fans will find this a big deal. Vlasic is introducing pickle chips made solely from pickles. Take a look at this. According to Food Business News, the company's new snack will be vacuum fried. Conagra Brands has not announced the release date as of yet. I can see a lot of people liking those, Jonathan Kegis.
Oh, for sure. A lot of pickle fans.
No doubt
about that.
Not a lot of severe weather fans, and unfortunately, that's something we got to keep a close eye on later today.
Yeah, Patrick, the potential is there for sure for severe weather later this afternoon, especially as the risk is highest east of Interstate 81 across Southside and Central Virginia. If watches and warnings are issued, important to know the difference both for severe thunderstorm watches or tornado watches and warnings. Again, a watch just means that conditions are favorable. There's nothing happening or nothing imminent at that point, but once a warning is issued, either a severe thunderstorm or a tornado warning, that means that a severe thunderstorm is happening or is about to occur in your area. So again, important to know the difference. Make sure you download the Storm Team 10 weather app. We're gonna track that system for you coming up at 5:47.
It's 5:42 now. A family in Richmond is cuddling their dog a little tighter this morning.
If it was not for her, I don't know that we would ever saw our dogs again. Not a lot of people, like I said, would stop for dogs on the side of the road, but especially ones that are as big as him. Exactly. We're just thankful.
How they owe a stranger for saving their pet's life.
It tastes better.
You're watching Virginia Today from 10 News, working for you.
Welcome back. It's 5:45 now. I'm Patrick McKee. New this morning, a dog in Richmond is reunited with his family after being hit by a car. Dude, the Mastiff, and his brother Leo escaped from their fenced-in yard. One woman was driving when she found Dude motionless in the road. She picked him up and drove him to the animal hospital.
Both kind of stopped, and when they stopped, I stopped and got out and just lifted my hatch and kind of went, and they both jumped in and just kind of then just sat there.
The woman's car has some blood stains from the dog. The owners hope to raise money to get her car cleaned. Crews are gearing up to tear down a historic dam in Lexington. Heavy construction equipment is now parked along the banks of the Maury River, but they have not started taking it down yet because the river levels are just too high. City Council approved the Department of Game and Inland Fisheries plan to demolish Jordan's Point Dam in November. U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service says the dam has significant structural problems. Up and down the East Coast and South, the weather is not looking good as we get closer to Easter weekend. Severe storms are leaving damage in parts of Texas. Rain and strong wind are causing downed trees and power lines. The National Weather Service has reported at least one tornado in Mississippi. Meanwhile, Arkansas is dealing with flooding. These storms are heading east today, expected to affect 100 million people from Georgia to Maine.
Tr-
trees, you make sure your power lines are clear and keep them trimmed back. You know, that's the main thing. Be proactive ahead of time before something happens.
Forecasters say the worst of this weather should be gone by tomorrow morning. It's when a cold front should push everything offshore. Some good news there, but unfortunately, we have to get through today and potential for some really nasty weather.
Yeah, we don't see a risk like this all that often. Certainly, we know what severe thunderstorms and tornadoes can do, but and typically don't happen here all that often, although recently we have had that severe weather threat. We're going to get into that severe weather threat in a second. That comes later on this afternoon and evening. First, picture of the day, a little foggy start here. Thank you, Jamie, for sending in this awesome shot there of the flowers in the foreground and the fog in the background. This was taken on Windy Gap Mountain. All is quiet now. That'll change this afternoon. Here's a live look in Blacksburg with our Virginia Tech SkyCam. Severe weather threat is there for us in Blacksburg. The bigger threat, though, going to be east of Interstate 81. We'll pinpoint that in a second. Temperatures into the mid-60s, dew points around 60. A lot of juice in the air for these thunderstorms to work with a little bit later on. Again, pretty quiet this morning, all things considered, at least in a relative sense. We are back into the mid-60s by 8 with a couple of showers around. Lower 70s this afternoon, and really once we get to lunchtime, that's when we start to look for the opportunity for those severe thunderstorms to come in. That risk stays with us through the early stages of this evening. Right now, just a few clouds, a couple of showers trying to push into the 77 corridor. This is the main line that we are tracking. Doesn't look too impressive at this point. That will change, though, as it continues to work its way off towards the east. We've got a strengthening system overhead. We've been talking about that upper low. Again, when you see the clouds out there, don't let your guard down. This is a very, very different day, so we don't need the sunshine to help juice the severe weather threat this afternoon. Here's 3-4 o'clock, and you see the darker reds. Each one of those little cells there can contain very, very strong winds, potentially more than 70 miles an hour. Again, this is a big time severe weather day. At least it has the potential to be that. There's 5-6 o'clock, and again, it's once we get east of the Blue Ridge that these could start to spin a little bit. And again, damaging wind going to be the main threat, but that tornado threat is also going to be there. You certainly don't see this every day. Again, that high risk for damaging winds going to be there, especially in the purple, in that red and purple color, again, along into the east of Interstate 81. That's the best opportunity to see wind gusts eclipse 70 miles an hour. Again, that'll do some big time damage to property. So that's something we are tracking very closely. Along with that, that flash flood threat is going to be there. Anywhere from 1 to 2 inches widespread rain expected. Isolated amounts could get around that 3-inch category. And again, that flood risk in that 6-hour ballpark, anywhere from 1.5 inches to about 2.5 inches. So flash flooding could start to occur pretty quickly. So a lot of hazards to be aware of today. Again, keep mentioning it, the Storm Contend Weather app. Great tool to get any alerts that are issued later this afternoon. Lower 70s this today, but again, it's the severe weather threat. Things quiet down tomorrow. If you do have Easter egg hunts tomorrow morning or afternoon, just going to be a couple of showers around, not a washout by any means. It will be cooler, so jackets will be needed. Lower 60s on Easter Sunday. There's an opportunity for a few showers to stick around. The same system that's bringing us the severe weather going to weaken considerably, of course, but just park itself here, keeping the clouds and showers around. That finally gets out of here on Monday. We're back in the mid-70s, warmer on Tuesday, Patrick.
All right, thank you, Jonathan. Time saver traffic this morning. We'll take a look at drive times as we remain accident-free. 35 minutes to drive. Danville to Martinsville, Alta Vista to Lynchburg, coming in at 26 minutes. A rolling masterpiece. You'll notice new works of art painted on the sides of Valley Metro buses. The Art by Bus program unveiled the pieces it will display. It's a unique way the Star City is working to promote public transportation through the arts. One piece by Ann Glover comes from the Roanoke City Art Collection. Another by Hollins University student Mandy Lamb.
At Valley Metro, a lot of people don't realize we provide over 2 million trips, and that's 2 million passengers a year. So that's 2 million individuals who get exposed to not only their neighborhoods and their ways to get through with transportation, they also get to experience art.
This is the 5th year of the program. New this morning, April 20th has been a special holiday for marijuana users for decades. The celebration is now so mainstream that corporate America is starting to embrace it. Businesses not even related to the cannabis industry are using April 20th or 420 to market new products aimed at marijuana enthusiasts. On Saturday, Lyft is offering a $4.20 credit on ride in some U.S. cities. A Denver restaurant is using the holiday to market a CBD-infused hamburger. Bad news for Pier 1 import lovers. You could see fewer of the home decor stores around. The company announced a new fiscal plan for 2020 And a big part of that plan is closing stores. Pier 1 says it's considering closing up to 45 locations on top of the 30 it's already closed. Even more could shut their doors if performance and sales goals are not met. Up 15% of its remaining stores could be on the chopping block. Time now is 5:52. We got five things you need to know coming up next. Stay with us. It's 5:54 now. Here's five things you need to know before you head out the door this morning. As we remember the 20th anniversary of the Columbine High School shooting, schools turned to artificial intelligence to prevent future violence. BARC is a company using AI and machine learning to analyze student activity on school-issued devices. The service is free for schools and currently covers about 2.5 million students. The American College of Physicians issues new screening guidelines for breast cancer. They say an average risk woman should begin mammogram screenings with every other year beginning at age 50. That differs from the American Cancer Society's recommendation of starting at 45. Performing mammograms every other year reduces the potential for false positives, overdiagnosis, and radiation exposure. Washington is pouring through more than 400 pages of what some consider riveting reading. The Mueller report is out. The conclusions have not changed, but for Democrats, the Mueller report raises more questions than answers. Republicans deny that Attorney General William Barr gave the report a positive spin for President Trump. A massive storm brought dangerous weather to the southeast, hitting parts of Louisiana hard. Some drivers were stranded and had to be rescued from the rising waters. The wind and rain also brought down trees north of New Orleans. Rain is expected to continue into the area today. Forecasters say the worst of this weather should be gone by Saturday morning. We're tracking this potential for severe weather right here at home as well.
That threat going to increase as we move forward through the afternoon and evening. Scattered showers and thunderstorms out there now. They are on the lighter side. Things much quieter tomorrow.
Next at 6, travel germ warnings. The things to keep in mind to keep you safe in airports and hotels before you head on vacation. Plus, overdosing concerns. A look at the drug 100 times stronger than morphine. As we continue here on Virginia Today on 10 News.
Camera included.
Live from WSLS, this is Virginia Today from 10 News, working for you.
Out in the public, a look at the highly anticipated Russia report and what people on Capitol Hill are thinking. Plus, severe weather headed our way. Storm Team 10 is working for you, tracking the rain and strong wind ahead of your Easter weekend. Good morning and happy Friday to you. We thank you for waking up with us. I'm Patrick McKee. Jenna is off this morning, tracking that potential for storms later today. And because of that, we've got one school system that's changing its schedule. Charlotte County Schools going to be closing at 12:30 this afternoon. We've got the full list for you on WSLS.com. That's all we've got for now, but that's likely to change as we go throughout this last day of the work week. Live look for you over the Roanoke Valley this morning. Breezy start to the day, otherwise still fairly calm. Let's get over to Jonathan Gagas in the Weather Center. Jonathan, what can we expect today?
Yeah, Patrick, a potentially very dangerous afternoon coming our way, especially east of Interstate 81. You see that darker red and darker orange color, mainly east of Interstate 81 through a lot of south side. For us to the Hill City as well, into Charlotte counties, Campbell counties, that's going to be our biggest risk, a risk that we typically do not see, something that happens just a few times a decade from the Storm Prediction Center. This moderate risk color here, that darker red across your screen, really continuing through Smith Mountain Lake into parts of Bedford County, points east into south side as well through Pennsylvania County. Damaging wind is going to be the main threat with this, but tornadoes not out of the question, especially across south side. We're going to highlight that risk coming up in about 15 minutes. Right now you are quiet getting into work, just a couple of showers out there. Temperatures to the mid 60s now, not moving much, only lower 70s today under the clouds. And again, those stronger storms really coming in after lunch through the evening. We are going to pinpoint those storms and talk about the risks and time these out for you coming up at 6:11. First, I want to get you a check on those roads. Everything quiet this morning, at least in the weather department right now.
And same thing, it looks like traffic wise so far. We're seeing no accidents on the area roads and things are moving along just fine. We're just a minor slowdown here and there. One of those on 221 between Floyd and Hillsville with that drive at 33 minutes. South Boston to Danville, we're sitting at 29 this morning. Washington is pouring through more than 400 pages of what some consider riveting reading. The Mueller report is out. The conclusions, they haven't changed, but there's plenty of detail feeding Democrats' desire to pick up where the special counsel left off. Tracy Potts is on Capitol Hill with where we go from here.
President Trump takes a second victory lap.
It was called no collusion, no obstruction.
But for Democrats, the Mueller report raises more questions than answers.
It's certainly not game over.
The report outlines 10 areas of possible obstruction, including multiple attempts to fire Special Counsel Robert Mueller. Mueller says he could not determine the president's intent.
Those acts of obstruction of justice, whether they are criminal or not, are deeply alarming.
Mueller left it to Congress to follow up.
And the responsibility now falls to Congress to hold the president accountable for his actions.
They not only want the full report.
No one outside the department has seen the unredacted report.
They want Mueller to testify.
I want to be able to ask Mr. Mueller, who is a former Republican-appointed FBI director, about what happened with this investigation.
Republicans deny Attorney General William Barr.
No collusion.
Gave the report a positive spin for President Trump.
I think it's rather laughable to see them turn their guns on him.
The report revealed President Trump was terrified when Mueller was appointed, telling aides, "This is the end of my presidency." The president's legal team had their own counter report all ready to go, but now the president's attorney says they probably won't release it. In Washington, Tracy Potts, 10 News, working for you.
Our coverage continues throughout the morning here on Virginia Today, as well as next on Today, starting at 7. Infinite gratitude and eternal appreciation. That's the praise given to first responders in Paris. Thousands gathered outside City Hall to honor the firefighters who saved Notre Dame Cathedral. France's interior minister says they will never be able to give them enough praise. Many of the relics inside were saved by them, including the crown of thorns and tunic of St. Louis. A local sheriff's office is remembering one deputy's beautiful personality and commitment to her work. Deputy Rose Clark died this week. Sheriff David Hill tells 10 News he believes she died of natural causes. He says she returned to Nelson County and applied at the sheriff's office to work in the courthouse serving papers.
Very loyal employee. And she was just a fine representation of our office, the community, the citizens, her family.
Every day when I would come in, I'd say, "Hello, Rose." And she would say, "Hi, Charlie." And it was such an infectious smile.
According to Hill, Clark also worked in Charlottesville for more than a decade before retiring in November. You can find their full statement on WSLS.com. New this morning, if you're headed out of town soon, you may want to pack hand sanitizer. Travel, it can be a germy endeavor, especially if you're flying to your final destination. A recent study finds airport security bins can carry more germs than a toilet. If you buy food at one of those airport grab-and-go stands, check the label to make sure food isn't expired. Doctors at Baylor College of Medicine say spoiled food could cause food poisoning. When you get to your seat, wipe down your tray table before you eat on it. And even if you've thoroughly cleaned, hotel rooms can harbor bacteria in some pretty sneaky places. Baylor also suggests using antiseptic wipes on remote controls, the telephone, and light switches. It's also a good idea to wash out the glasses left in bathrooms. Even if they're clean, studies have shown that flushing toilets can contaminate nearby surfaces. Some Southwest Virginia communities are getting recognition. Three local areas are in the top 10 of Virginia's safest cities. SafeHome.org ranked Salem as fifth. The study found only 16 violent crimes happened in the city last year. Rounding out the top 10 is Lynchburg, coming in at number 8, and Christiansburg at number 9. A major upgrade to the local power grid. Appalachian Power just spent $38 million in renovations in downtown Roanoke. At first glance, you won't notice it because it's all underground. 10 News got an exclusive look at the underground system that's expected to reduce the number of power outages and speed up response times. The new infrastructure is also attractive to potential new businesses.
When we work with businesses that want to locate into our area, especially a downtown area, they ask about infrastructure, and now we can say that we have a brand new system in Roanoke that's ready to serve your needs.
This new system is expected to last for decades. New this morning, a team of researchers are using math to help design a fair schedule for teams in the NFL. Right now, experts say there are more possibilities to schedule 32 teams in a year than there are atoms in the universe. A ton of possibilities. Inevitably, some teams are on the short end of the stick. The Buffalo Bills have voiced concerns. Between 2002 and 2014, the Bills have twice as many games against teams coming off a bye week or a Thursday night game.
We were able to improve the 2016 schedule after the fact. They like that, and that eventually led to this three-year contract.
Now the NFL is giving them access to all the schedules to see if they're able to find a better approach. While researchers say there will never be a perfect schedule, they will try to minimize the number of bad things. 6:08 now in What's News Today, we'll get a look at Carilion Clinic's drug take-back boxes. The boxes have been installed at all hospitals and pharmacies. You can dispose of leftover medication throughout the year. Those boxes were installed in response to the opioid crisis. The New River Health District holds a walk-in clinic today. Several services will be offered, including vaccines, family planning, and testing for sexually transmitted diseases. The clinic runs from 8:30 to noon at the Montgomery County Health Department. If you're traveling for Easter, it's going to get a little easier for you today. Road crews will lift many lane closures starting at noon today, and that will last through noon on Tuesday. The Virginia Tech Corps of Cadets will take part in the Jaffe Eager Squad and Eager Individual Drills competitions today. Cadets practice for hours in the month leading up to the competition. First year and sophomore cadets will take part. 6:08 now, we'll get back over to Jonathan Kegis with an update on today's forecast. Got to be weather aware today.
Yeah, no doubt about that. Things are quiet right now. Just a couple of very, very light showers out there. But this is the line we are tracking. Again, not looking too ominous just yet. That is likely going to change, though, as it moves into our region a little bit later on this afternoon and evening, mainly as we close in on lunch and then through the afternoon and evening, especially. You see the darker reds there, tornado watch box for the panhandle of Florida, getting into Alabama and Georgia as well. Big time risk for severe weather. Again, some of the biggest risks you ever see, at least in our region. You see there the threats going to be the potential for damaging winds, tornadoes, and very heavy rain. Those bigger threats, especially east of Interstate 81, east of Roanoke, that is going to include Bedford, Lynchburg, Smith Mountain Lake, Martinsville into Gretna, Chatham, Danville, South Boston in this moderate risk. Again, we rarely see those issued by the Storm Prediction Center. That is 4 out of 5 on their severe weather scale. Again, that's a big time risk for the region. Again, that risk east of the Blue Ridge, that enhanced and moderate risk, slight risk, relatively speaking, lesser opportunity, but still a heightened risk for severe weather areas east of the Blue Ridge. Patrick, we're going to track this system coming up in about 5 minutes.
We'll see you then, Jonathan. Thank you. 6:10 now, still to come this morning, keeping your family safe. The do's and don'ts to keep in mind before using your microwave. And then new at 6:40, new breast cancer guidelines. The debate over when you should start getting a mammogram. But next, Americans waste $160 billion in produce each year. How to make it last long?
It's a lot of water.
6:13 now, new this morning. Each year, about $160 billion in produce is thrown away in the United States. Here are some things you can do to lengthen its life. Save yourself a little money as well. Breaking your banana bunch apart can make them last 2 weeks compared to just one together. If your cheeses aren't lasting the average 3 weeks in the fridge, pay attention to your fingers. To avoid transferring bacteria and promoting mold growth, don't touch it when you cut it. Place paper towel over lettuce to absorb moisture and prevent wilting. And storing citrus in a cool, dark place to lengthen their lives. For the rest of your home, make flowers last. Hadn't heard of this one before. Make them last by adding a cap of vodka or bleach to the water. New this morning, the microwave is convenient to cook food quickly. We're working for you on some do's and don'ts when using the appliance. A study published in the Journal of Food Science cooked 20 different vegetables. It found microwaving and baking preserve nutrients better than boiling. Dietitian Shreela Sharma says the most common microwave dish is typically leftovers. She says you should heat food in glass containers or paper plates and bowls. There are no major studies showing microwaving in plastics dangerous, but you should try to avoid it. And make sure to stop and stir food while it's reheating.
Because otherwise, if some parts are heated more than the others, that part will cook faster than the other parts.
Now, she recommends using a thermometer to make sure vegetables and meat reach 165 degrees to eliminate bacteria. A drug 10,000 times stronger than morphine is being used recreationally. The DEA is warning about carfentanil. They say three people in San Diego area are dead after overdosing on the synthetic drug. The drug is normally used as a tranquilizer for large zoo animals. It's so dangerous, it poses a risk to first responders who accidentally come in contact with it.
This has no respect for anyone. Any one of us could become addicted to this drug and succumb to it. And it's extremely addicting. You only need to be exposed to it once and you will be hooked.
The DEA reports some are mixing the drug into a pill to look like OxyContin or Xanax. A local manufacturing company is moving to Floyd and bringing 28 jobs with it. Positions at Thomas Industrial Fabrication include welders, mechanics, engineers, and office support. It will move into the former Dreaming Creek property from its current headquarters in Patrick County. The owners are from Floyd, and they say it's a great fit because of the high school's strong welding program. Governor Northam announces 45 new jobs are headed to Bath County. Speyside Bourbon Stave Mill in Virginia is investing $100,000 to expand its facility. The company will add new equipment and a second shift. This time next year, construction should be well underway for Unique Village in Danville. Habitat for Humanity plans to build a habitat village and will have dozens of homes. The announcement was made this week, but planning for the village has taken 10 years. Habitat villages are all across the nation, including in Lynchburg and Charlottesville, but this is the first in Danville.
Once we have a better feel for how quickly we can construct the houses, we will do a better job of, you know, being able to recruit the families. We do anticipate that this will be highly desirable.
Now, Habitat is in need of donations of both labor and money for the village. To find out how you can help, head to our website, WSLS.com. In this morning's Consumer Watch, Apple is making it easier for you to recycle your old iPhones. The company's quadrupling the number of drop-off recycling locations all across the nation. You can turn in your old devices at any Apple store, Best Buy, or online through the Apple Trade-In program. The company's recycling robot, Daisy, can disassemble 200 phones per hour, or 1.2 million a year. Daisy also recovers important materials such as aluminum and tin, which are recycled back into the manufacturing process. Homes with solar panels not only help save on energy costs, but they can also potentially increase the value of your home. According to a new report from Zillow, homes with solar energy systems sold for about 4% more than homes without. The study finds more than 80% of home buyers say energy efficient features are important. Solar panel homes sold for more than $9,000 in additional cash. Anything to save a little bit of money down the road going to go a long way toward helping you when you try to sell your home.
No doubt about that. We're not going to see much sun today, and now typically that would be good news to hold down severe weather threat. Today is a much, much different setup than what we typically would see. It doesn't matter how much sun we see, that severe threat's still going to be very, very high, especially east of Interstate 81. Quiet now, and for the morning commute, we're going to stay that way. Here is a live look in Roanoke with our Carilion Skycam. Temperatures now into the mid-60s, only going to top out in the lower 70s later today. Good morning in Gretna. We're back to the mid-50s at the bus stop. A few showers around. The better chance for rain and severe thunderstorms coming by the time we get off the school bus. Temperatures into the mid-70s. Again, across Southside, east of the Blue Ridge especially, want to pay close attention to this. Superintendents that are watching, teachers, please be vigilant with releasing the kids. It's a day like that where things could get pretty dangerous into the afternoon. Satellite and radar, you see there, there's the storms off towards our west. That line really starting to materialize now. You see the darker reds in North Georgia, so evidence that, again, that this system is going to continue to strengthen as we've been talking about for the last couple of days now. Tornado watch box into parts of Florida, Georgia, into Alabama. We will likely see much more of those, especially in our area, issued today. Tracking that, here is 3 o'clock, and it's these darker reds, purples, and oranges. Each one of these storms can contain very, very strong wind gusts. The potential for these damaging wind gusts to eclipse 70 miles an hour. So it's not just your run-of-the-mill severe thunderstorms where we could have some damage. These are likely going to be big time severe thunderstorms. There's 5-6 o'clock. Again, your commute home from work could be a rocky one as very heavy rain and the potential for those damaging winds stay with us. Things quiet down considerably after about 8 or 9 o'clock, with just a few stray showers lingering behind this line. Again, damaging wind is going to be the main threat. The potential is going to be there for these wind gusts to eclipse 70, maybe even 75 miles an hour. Flash flooding threat is elevated. The tornado threat today is elevated, especially across Southside, places like Martinsville, Danville, even into Lynchburg. Potential is there for tornadoes. Again, still the damaging wind going to be the main threat. Lightning threat is going to be there. The hail threat not going to be as high, due to the fact, again, we're not going to see a lot of sunshine. The instability is not going to be cranked up. There is that enhanced tornado risk again through South Boston into Danville, Gretna, Chatham. Still not zero there, where that possible color is, this orange, through Lynchburg, Smith Mountain Lake into Martinsville. So really, especially in these areas east of Interstate 81, please pay close attention. Have a way to get your warnings. The Storm Team 10 weather app, a great tool for a day like today. Track those storms. And again, to get those warnings and watches if they are issued. Temperatures into the mid-50s on Easter Sunday by 10 o'clock. I think there will be a couple of showers around now. This upper low that's going to cause a severe weather, going to weaken, but it's going to make Virginia home for a couple of days for tomorrow and into Sunday. Severe thunderstorms going to be likely again this afternoon. Temperatures tonight with a couple of showers and fog developing back into the upper 40s and low 50s. Cooler day tomorrow with a few showers. Not a washout, though, if you have Easter egg hunts. Jacket's going to be needed, though. Lower 60s on Sunday with a stray shower or two. Much, much better weather coming our way. Second half of Easter Sunday and into Monday, Patrick.
Download the Storm Team 10 weather app if you don't have it already. Thank you, Jonathan. Time saver traffic this morning. Drive times Roanoke to Blacksburg coming in at 67 minutes. A little slower than average there. Near average as we go Blacksburg to Roanoke northbound. That drive coming in at 56 minutes.
This is your daily tech and business briefing from Cheddar. Kroger is launching an autonomous delivery service. The grocery giant is partnering with the robotics company Neuro to use its self-driving fleet to deliver groceries. Kroger will begin the service in Houston using Neuro's fleet of Toyota Priuses. Its next-generation driverless vehicles will be rolled out later this year. Customers will be able to order same-day delivery in any day of the week. This comes amid a rush of partnerships in the grocery and package delivery space. And the Canadian cannabis company Canopy Growth has struck a $3.4 billion deal to buy Acreage Holding, but it doesn't take effect until the U.S. legalizes marijuana. Until then, the two companies will operate independently. Acreage is one of the largest multi-state cannabis operators in the U.S. and has attracted attention thanks in part to one of its directors, former House Speaker John Boehner. This is the latest in a string of deals in the fast-growing marijuana industry. And just because you order gluten-free bread, that doesn't mean your food is actually gluten-free. A new study found that over one-third of restaurants' foods that are labeled gluten-free actually do contain gluten. And the study also found that more than half of gluten-free pizza and pasta on menus tested positive for the protein. And that's your Cheddar Business and Tech Update. I'm Tim Stenebeck from the floor of the New York Stock Exchange.
Time now is 6:22. Still to come this morning, flood-fighting technology. A new system available now that can predict where rivers could flood. Plus, a successful season. Despite only being in Roanoke for a short time, the Rail Yard Dogs are celebrating. Community response.
You're watching Virginia Today from 10 News, working for you.
Welcome back. It's 6:25 now. I'm Patrick McKee. The Roanoke Rail Yard Dogs is getting ready to wrap up its third season, and the team says it's already beat their marks. The Dogs made history with a trip to the semifinals for the first time ever. Although the team fell to Birmingham last night, they're still in the hunt for the championship. Minor league hockey in the past has come and gone in Roanoke, which left some people skeptical. But one of the local minority owners says not only is Roanoke embracing the team loves Roanoke.
You know, I feel like we've checked a lot of the boxes. We're doing the right things. We're making hockey exciting. We're making it accessible. It's entertaining for families. If we can do that, we're doing a great service to the Valley.
Average game attendances continue to grow each year. Last night, ticket sales were up by more than 1,000 for a normal Thursday night game. If you're worried ahead of today's storms, there's now new technology designed to help. Drones, supercomputers, and underwater sonar scans are being used to maintain flood control projects. It also can predict where rivers could flood. Scientists say 13 million Americans are at risk of major flood damage. Emergency officials can also simulate scenarios such as predicting what could happen if a dam or levee breaks. Jonathan Kegg has tracked the potential for that severe weather later today, some of which could bring us some flooding as the heavy rains possibility as well.
Yeah, that's right. Mainly on those smaller creeks and streams this go around. Right now we are quiet, just a couple of showers early, but then once we get past lunch, that's when we see at least the threat really ramp up for severe weather across the region later this afternoon and into the evening. Things quiet down big time after we get past midnight tonight. Just a couple of showers with us into tomorrow. The threat for tornadoes is there mainly across south side. Again, just going over a little bit of safety here. It's with even a severe thunderstorm warning. You want to make sure you're away from windows. And on a day like today where the wind energy is so strong, we could have gusts 60 to 70, 75 miles an hour. Even when those severe thunderstorm warnings are issued today, make sure you would get away from those windows. Get into a basement, someplace sturdy for sure. If you're in a mobile home, you want to get out of that. If a tornado warning is issued, just make sure you're getting into a safer place. If there's a shelter, if you're in a mobile home park, go there. If you're near a ditch, that's where you want to be. Cover yourself with any kind of pillows, blankets, protect that head. Number one reason people die in tornadoes is being hit by that flying debris, Patrick.
Good advice. Thank you, Jonathan. 6:28 now, still to come this morning, getting your driving privileges back. How simple it is to start driving again. Plus, celebrating a special birthday. Forget the presents. It's about something more from one local veteran's 100th. How your act of kindness can make all the difference. And 20 years later, the technology hoping to help prevent school shootings.
Remarkable.
Live from WSLS, this is Virginia Today from 10 News, working for you.
Out of a job, the Virginia resource officer connected to a white nationalist group. Plus, learning from mistakes, a deadly decision lands a New River Valley teen in detention. The sentence the teen received. Good morning and happy Friday to you. We thank you for waking up with us. I'm Patrick McKee. Jenna has the morning off. I do want to let you know Charlotte County Schools altering the schedule for today due to likely the severe weather coming in later today. Charlotte County Schools getting out at 12:30 this afternoon. As we get more of these in, and we may get a few more in during the day, you'll find them on WSLS.com. Live look outside this morning over Martinsville. Lots of clouds in place this morning. A bit of a breeze as well. Jonathan Kegges is working for you as he tracks the potential for severe weather later today. Jonathan, what can we expect to see?
Yeah, Patrick, later on this afternoon, things could be a little rocking, especially east of Roanoke, getting into Lynchburg, Smith Mountain Lake, Martinsville. You see it there, the orange and red on your screen. This is a rare issuance from the Storm Prediction Center. Again, the moderate risk, that's 4 out of 5 on the severe weather scale there. You not see that too often in these parts. Lynchburg from Smith Mountain Lake to Martinsville points east into Danville, Gretna, Chatham into South Boston, Virgilina, getting into Charlotte County, Charlotte Courthouse, Phoenix, all under the gun for a big time severe weather day, potentially very dangerous afternoon. Damaging wind, the main threat, but the tornado threat also elevated, especially east of Interstate 81. In that orange color, in that red color. So know where you are on the maps this afternoon and pay close attention. Very quiet now, just a couple of showers. We'll see mainly cloudy skies, temperatures to get you out the door in the mid-60s. We're going to have much more on this severe weather threat. We're going to time the threat in and talk about the impacts to you coming up at 6:47. First, though, do want to get you a check on those roads this morning with your Time Saver traffic report.
And so far, so good, Jonathan. As we take a look, we are seeing drive times coming in 38 minutes. Clifton Forge to Roanoke to Lynchburg. A 58-minute drive. Tomorrow marks the 20th anniversary of the Columbine High School shooting. Since then, schools have turned to technology to help prevent similar events from happening. Liz McLaughlin has more on how this tech is helping.
In the 2 decades since Columbine, America has seen school shooting tragedies repeat themselves time and time again.
Enough is enough!
Now, some hope artificial intelligence can play a role in preventing future violence.
Technology has the amazing capacity to identify those most at risk to become a threat before they actually do.
BARC is one of a handful of companies that uses AI and machine learning to analyze student activity on school-issued devices, looking for warning signs and flagging students that may harm themselves or others.
Violent gaming platforms, online chat forums, even on Google Docs, writing suicide notes or plans to commit mass attacks.
BARC then sends alerts to parents, school officials, and in the most extreme cases, law enforcement.
To date, our artificial intelligence has escalated 16 credible school shooting threats to the FBI.
BARC offers the service for free to schools, and it currently covers about 2.5 million students. There are occasional false positives, and schools can't police students' personal devices. But that's where parents can step in.
Any sort of sign that something is off with your child is a sign that you need to take a more active role in engaging with what's going on.
The hope that early intervention will curb acts of violence before they happen. Liz McLaughlin, NBC News.
A Virginia school resource officer is out of a job this morning after claims he's associated with a white nationalist group. The Chesterfield Police Department says Officer Dan Morley will not return to the force. When he started, the allegations of his association with the group had not yet come to light. But last month, he was accused of being involved with one which has been designated by the Southern Poverty Law Center as a hate group. In a statement, the police chief says, in part, policing in today's times is challenging, and to be successful, it requires trust. He says the officer's activities make it impossible for him to continue. We got the full statement for you online at WSLS.com. Happening today, an Ohio man accused of pretending to be a missing Kentucky boy is scheduled to be in court. 23-year-old Michael Rennie is charged with two counts of making false statements and one count of aggravated identity theft. Authorities say Rennie told investigators he was Timothy Pitson, a boy who had gone missing in 2011. DNA tests later determined Rennie was not the boy. According to investigators, Rennie came up with the ruse after watching a news story on Pitson. Local deputies are looking for two people this morning who may have witnessed a robbery outside of a local bank. The Amherst County Sheriff's Office says deputies want to talk to Arthur Tucker and Shanta Wolfock. They say the armed robbery happened last Friday in the parking lot of the Madison Heights BB&T. If you know where they are, you're asked to call police. A judge hopes the punishment handed down to a teen driver involved in a deadly crash will be a lesson to others. The 16-year-old, who 10 News is choosing not to identify because of his age, was driving when Ashland Poole was thrown from the passenger seat and killed in Christiansburg last July. An investigation found he was traveling more than 86 miles an hour. That's more than twice the legal speed limit. His sentence includes 30 days detention, community service, and his license was suspended. New this morning, many people who get their driving privileges back later this year will not have to complete anything extra to start driving again legally. According to the DMV, starting on July 1st, if you have a physical license and it's not expired, you're good to get behind the wheel. If you have no physical license or an expired one, you'll have to go to the DMV for replacement or renewal, but you don't have to pay the $145 reinstatement fee. 6:37 now, the threat of severe weather, it's here. A look at what the storms later today could bring for us.
The best or nothing.
It's almost 6:40 now. In Women's Health this morning, the American College of Physicians issues new screening guidelines for breast cancer. They say an average risk woman should begin mammogram screenings every other year, beginning at age 50. The American College of Physicians guidelines differs from the American Cancer Society, which recommends beginning screenings at age 45, continuing them annually until 54, and then going every other year. Performing mammograms every other year reduces the potential for false positives, overdiagnosis, overtreatment, and radiation exposure. But all women should have a conversation with her doctor to develop a plan that's right for her.
Patients should also be paying attention to self-breast exams, going in for their annual clinical exams, and then make a shared decision with their physician what's right for them.
These new guidelines do not apply to patients who have prior abnormal screening results or a higher risk for breast cancer. You can help one local veteran have an even more special 100th birthday. There's a social media campaign to send the Lexington man 100 birthday cards for his big day. This picture has been shared thousands of times already, and the World War II veteran has dozens of cards already in his mailbox. His retirement home's administrator says she wanted to do something but never imagined that so many people would wish him well.
I'm not overly emotional, but some of this, when I was reading his cards to him yesterday, it kind of was hard for me to read to him because I wanted to tear up and cry, because 100 years old, World War II veteran, it's just amazing. Again, nobody deserves it more than Ray.
The home is also planning a party for his birthday. If you want to mail him a card, you can find the address on our website at WSLS.com. Jonathan Kagas, it's always wonderful to see somebody celebrating a big milestone like this and everybody getting involved.
That is fantastic for sure. What is not fantastic, Patrick, the weather this afternoon. We've been talking about this for at least the potential for it for the past couple of days. Now, always important to know the difference between a watch and a warning if some are issued this afternoon. Severe thunderstorm or tornado watch is a warning. Again, a watch in both degrees just means that the conditions are favorable for the severe thunderstorms or tornadoes to develop. A warning would mean, though, that one is happening or is about to occur, and that's when you need to take action. So again, important to know that. Storm Team 10 Weather App, a great tool to get any watches or warnings that are issued by the National Weather Service later on this afternoon and evening. We're tracking that system, Patrick, coming up at 6:47.
A family in Richmond's cuddling their dog a little tighter this morning.
If it was not for her, I don't know that we would ever saw our dogs again. Right. Not a lot of people, like I said, would stop for dogs on the side of the road, but especially ones that are as big as him. Exactly. We're just thankful.
How they owe a stranger for saving their pet's life.
John Deere Equipment.
You're watching Virginia Today from 10 News, working for you.
Welcome back on this Friday morning. It's 6:45 now. I'm Patrick McKee. New this morning, a dog in Richmond is reunited with his family after being hit by a car. Dude, the Mastiff, and his brother Leo escaped from their fenced-in yard. One woman was driving when she found Dude motionless in the road. She picked him up and drove him to an animal hospital.
Both kind of stopped, and when they stopped, I stopped and got out and just lifted my hatch and kind of went, and they both jumped in and just kind of then just sat there.
The woman's car has some blood stains from the dog. The owners hope to raise money to get it cleaned for her. Up and down the East Coast and South, the weather is not looking good heading into the Easter weekend. Severe storms are leaving damage in parts of Texas. Rain and strong winds are causing downed trees and power lines. The National Weather Service has reported at least one tornado in Mississippi. In Arkansas, they're dealing with flooding there. These storms are heading east today, expecting to affect around 100 million people from Georgia to Maine.
Trees, make sure your power lines are clear and keep them trimmed back. You know, that's the main thing. Be proactive ahead of time before something happens.
Forecasters say the worst of this weather should be gone by tomorrow morning. That's when a cold front is going to be pushing offshore and gets it all out of here. And that can't come soon enough, especially Jonathan Kegas, for what looks to be worsening conditions for us from what we've been seeing the past couple of days.
Yeah, the cold front, while it's going to give us a clean sweep, it's also the reason that we're going to have the severe weather. So don't be fooled there with that being the good news out of the deal. We're going to get into that severe weather threat. We do have the picture of the day for you to start things off. A nice colorful shot here, some of the flowers in the foreground. Thank you, Jamie, for sending in this awesome shot coming in on Windy Gap Mountain. All is cloudy right now. All is quiet across much of the region this morning. Here's a live look with our Virginia Tech Skycam in Blacksburg. Temperatures into the mid-60s. It's a little muggy out there as well. Again, don't be fooled by the clouds. We often talk about you needing the sunshine to really ramp up the severe weather threat. And if we had sunshine, that threat would even be higher. But on a day like today, with the dynamics coming into play, severe weather does not need the sunshine to get going this afternoon. So be vigilant and don't let your guard down. Temperatures around 70 by noon, and it's after lunch or shortly thereafter where that severe threat really going to start ramping up. We're going to keep that rolling through the evening and through late tonight as well. Mainly after 9 or 10 o'clock, that threat going to start to come down a little bit. Right now, all is quiet, though. We are mainly cloudy, a couple of showers popping. They are well below severe levels. Just some light rain here. You see this line, though, really starting to intensify again, coming out of the west through parts of eastern Tennessee, western North Carolina. This is the main line that we are tracking that is likely going to trigger a lot of severe weather, especially east of Interstate 81 later today. Tracking that here, here's 3 o'clock. There are the darker reds and purples indicating the strongest thunderstorms. And it's in those storms, that's where wind gusts can top 70 miles an hour at times. And the greatest threat for that to happen going to be east of Roanoke, east of Lexington, getting into Lynchburg, Smith Mountain Lake, and Martinsville here. These storms also east of the Blue Ridge will have the opportunity to spin. So the tornado threat definitely nowhere close to zero. It's a little more elevated today. Still the main threat, though, going to be damaging winds in this red and purple area. That's the best opportunity for significant damaging winds where those wind gusts could top 70 to 75 miles an hour at times. Again, your routine severe thunderstorm warning, that warning gets issued with those winds around 60 miles an hour. These have the potential potential to be much, much stronger than just your typical severe thunderstorm. So please be vigilant this afternoon. Along with that damaging wind threat, we also have that flash flood threat. 1 to 2 inches of rain widespread expected. Some places on an isolated scale could close in on 3 to 4 inches. Only going to take about an inch and a half area wide to get that flash flooding going again in a 6-hour span. So that's going to happen quickly. So a lot of things to pay attention to today. Also, your evening commute likely going to be a little rocky with those damaging winds out there. Lower 70s this afternoon. Again, it's all about the storm chances on this Good Friday. Upper 50s tomorrow with a few showers. If you are planning on going out tomorrow for Easter egg hunts in the morning, it's not a washout, just jacket-worthy weather, a few stray showers. Same deal on Easter Sunday. This system going to park itself over Virginia, keeping now a couple of showers around. Temperatures back into the lower 60s. Much, much better weather getting into Monday afternoon and into Tuesday. A lot of these storms, Patrick, going to cross during when school is letting out. Important for teachers and superintendents to be paying close attention to the weather this afternoon so no one gets stranded out there as these buses are dropping off the kids.
Good advice there. In Charlotte County schools are going to be letting out at 12:30 because of that. If we get any more of those school delays or closings in, we'll pass them along to you on WSLS.com. Accident-free on time-saver traffic this morning. We are seeing your usual slowdown starting to develop. It looks like on 460, especially where it goes from 3 lanes down to 2. Looks like also on Route 24 as you approach 581. Get a green light there and things will start to thin out a little bit more. But this time of the morning, it always gets busy there. A rolling masterpiece. You'll notice new works of art painted on the sides of Valley Metro buses. The Art by Bus program unveiled the pieces it will display. It's a unique way the Star City is working to promote public transportation through the arts. One piece by Ann Glover comes from the Roanoke City Art Collection. The other was designed by Holland University art student Mandy Lamb.
At Valley Metro, a lot of people don't realize we provide over 2 million trips. And that's 2 million passengers a year. So that's 2 million individuals who get exposed to not only their neighborhoods and their ways to get through with transportation, they also get to experience art.
This is the 5th year of the program. New this morning, April 20th has been a special holiday for marijuana users for decades. Celebration is now so mainstream that corporate America is starting to embrace it. Businesses not even related to cannabis are using April 20th or 420 to market new products aimed at marijuana enthusiasts. On Saturday, Lyft is offering a $4.20 credit on a ride in some U.S. cities. A Denver restaurant is using the holiday to market a CBD-infused hamburger. There's bad news for Pier 1 import fans. You could see fewer of the home decor stores around. The company announced a new fiscal plan for 2020. A big part of it is closing stores. Pier 1 says it's considering closing up to 45 locations on top of the 30 it's already shuttered. Even more could shut their doors if performance and sales goals aren't met. Up to 15% of the remaining stores could end up on the chopping block. 6:52 now. We got 5 things you need to know coming up next. Stay with us. 6:55 now. Here's 5 things you need to know before heading out the door this morning. As we remember the 20th anniversary of the Columbine High School shooting, schools turn to artificial intelligence to prevent future violence. BARC is a company using AI and machine learning to analyze student activity on school-issued devices. The service is for free to schools and currently covers about 2.5 million students. The American College of Physicians issued new screening guidelines for breast cancer. They say an average risk woman should begin mammogram screenings every other year, starting at age 50. Now, this differs from the American Cancer Society, which recommends beginning at 45. Performing mammograms every other year reduces the potential for false positives, overdiagnosis, and radiation exposure. Washington is pouring through more than 400 pages of what some consider riveting reading, the Mueller Report. The conclusions, they haven't changed, but for Democrats, the Mueller report raises more questions than answers. The report a positive spin for President Trump. A massive storm brought dangerous weather to the southeast, hitting parts of Louisiana hard. Some drivers were stranded and had to be rescued from the rising waters. The wind and rain also brought down trees north of New Orleans. Rain's expected to continue in the area today. Forecasters say the worst of this storm system should be gone by tomorrow morning, but Jonathan Kegis is working for you, saying you got to watch out for today.
Yeah, today is the big day, at least in terms of the severe weather potential. One of the biggest days we've seen in quite some time in terms of widespread severe potential. Hoping this just falls apart. We can just get on with our afternoon and evening. Right now, it does not look like that's going to be the case, though. Temperatures back in the low 70s today, really after lunch through late this evening. That's going to be our main risk time for very, very strong winds, damaging winds in excess of 70 miles an hour, potentially, especially right along Interstate 81 and points east through south side. Tomorrow, much quieter. If you have Easter egg hunts going on tomorrow or Easter Sunday, just a slight chance for a few showers around tomorrow morning into the afternoon. A stray shower now possible on Sunday. The same system bringing the severe weather. Going to be much, much weaker, but it's also going to park itself on top of us for a couple of days, improving weather big time Easter Sunday through early next week. But again, download the Storm Team 10 weather app. It's a great tool. You can track those storms right to your location. And of course, the big one to get those alerts from the National Weather Service right in the palm of your hand.
All right, that is our time together here on this Friday morning. The Today Show is coming your way next. Have a great weekend.